So in this video, I want to show you the best way to identify arsenic poisoning, okay? It's through the nails. There's a condition called leukonychia. The Greek word for leuko means white, and then onchi is the nail. Leukonychia is basically a horizontal white band on your nails, and that can be arsenic poisoning. But there are many other symptoms as well. One would be headache, confusion, severe diarrhea because your body's trying to get rid of it, drowsiness, you're vomiting blood, you have blood in the urine, hair loss, cramping, stomach pain, your skin is darkening, your skin is getting thicker, night blindness, which mimics a vitamin A deficiency because arsenic depletes your vitamin A, vitamin B1 deficiency because arsenic blocks the absorption of vitamin B1, and that will give you a whole series of additional symptoms. An increase of hydrogen peroxide, that can affect the color of your hair, and you'll lose your pigment. You can actually go gray, and even convulsions. And other than that, you're doing pretty good. Now, a couple reasons why you may have arsenic poisoning. One is you're consuming rice. Rice has been found to have high levels of arsenic. Also, you could get it from your water supply. There's been many outbreaks around the world where there's been contamination of arsenic in the water supply, and you know, even thousands of people in certain areas are becoming exposed to it. And also, there's been certain types of wine that have been tested positive for arsenic, probably because of contamination with the water that the plant pulled it in. You have the pollution or the byproduct of arsenic from manufacturing and things like that. But then you also have arsenic in the soil as a natural occurrence. You also have fluoride, you have mercury, cadmium, you have a lot of different heavy metals. What happens is the plant will absorb the minerals and heavy metals, okay, because every single plant has very, very small amounts of these heavy metals that are considered toxic in large amounts. And I just want to mention that when you get a trace mineral product that is plant-based, you're going to get small amounts of all the heavy metals. And I just want to mention that the chemistry or how that heavy metal is bound in a plant versus in the soil is very, very different. So in a plant, you have the chemistry as organic minerals. Okay, in soil, it's inorganic. The definition of organic that I'm using is not the same as like without pesticides. The other definition of organic is that it's a plant-based chemical bond that greatly reduces the toxicity. But if you're getting some type of industrial byproduct that's in the soil that this plant is growing on, especially arsenic, then that plant could have very high levels of arsenic. So even though it may be an organic chemical bond because it's plant-based arsenic, that's gonna be a lot more toxic because of the concentration. But typically if we're not dealing with this high amounts of a certain heavy metal, it's nothing to worry about. If you suspect that you have arsenic poisoning, you could actually get a hair analysis to pick it up. There's other tests that you can do. You can get a blood test. The detox remedies for arsenic poisoning that I would recommend would be blue-green algae because it's a chelator and it can actually pull out certain heavy metals. Selenium will also help to detoxify arsenic. If you haven't seen my other video on arsenic, I put it up right here. Check it out.